You know, my distinguished colleague from Texas just made the observation that Justice Thomas has been subjected to a high-tech lynching. It's quite extraordinary. And I believe, Mr. Paoletta, you've echoed a similar sentiment. I think your quote is, "Many on the left hate Justice Thomas because he is a black conservative who has never bowed to those who demand that he must think a certain way because of the color of his skin." What evidence do you have to support that incendiary charge?
When Chairman Benny Thompson calls him an Uncle Tom because of his views on voter ID and affirmative action, when in fact more black Americans support voter ID and with respect to affirmative action in college education, they're 62% opposed to it. So that is the most vile, disgusting thing you can say. And so, yes, that's the evidence I just gave you.
Reclaiming my time.
Yes.
There are a lot of vile, disgusting things that can
be said.
Well,
you just asked me for an example.
The notion that is, right, when some members on this side of the aisle and others have been called the N-word throughout different points of our life belies the point that you have a particular bias. And it's an overstatement, which is not surprising when you look at the balance of your testimony. And if Chairman Benny Thompson has an observation to make, he's entitled to free speech. You apparently believe that Jenny Thomas, regardless of how many conflicts she has, is entitled to her own political opinions as well.
Can I give you another example?
No.
Mr. Paoletta, I wanted to give you an opportunity to extend your remarks regarding instances of racism that you believe Justice Thomas encountered as a consequence of his skin color and his politics.
Sure. I think it's the I have it in my written testimony, too. It's this narrative that Justice Thomas is a lackey of Justice Scalia, of Judge Silberman when he was on the court. And the writing is all that he is incapable of being a justice. Which is so belied by the facts. He's the most independent thinking justice, probably in history. He writes the most opinions per year of any justice.
When someone calls a black person an Uncle Tom, is that a racist attack?
Yeah, I think it is. I think it's a disgusting attack.
Do any of the other panelists dispute that testimony? Does anyone think that there's a non-racist way to call a black person an Uncle Tom? How should we think about the fact that the chairman of the January 6th committee, the chairman of the Homeland Security Committee, used what all of you concede is a racist attack against Justice Thomas?
Congressman Jeffries asked me for an example. I gave it to him. I'll let others address it, but I just think it is indicative of the hatred that is directed towards Justice Thomas for his views.
You believe it's a racist trope to designate Justice Thomas as like uniquely unintelligent or persuadable. You believe it's a racist trope to call him an Uncle Tom, and you believe that this committee is a continuation of that effort.
Yes, and I believe it was, yes, I believe it started when he first came to town in 1980 and joined the Murray
administration. Let's hope it ends. I yield back.
Hey guys, if you like smart, nuanced, left-right conversations and interviews in a world where there are very few of those.
Do you want to hear both sides of an issue? Do you want to hear people debate it out?
Then you need to subscribe to our new YouTube channel by clicking the link in the description or the pop-up button that appears on your screen.